You murdered a colleague of mine 2 weeks ago. In cold blood, for no reason other than that you love killing.
Ooh.
He had a lot of different names, depending on where in the world he was, but there's only one that matters. You killed 008. And I'm 007.
Just called green, innit?
Sounds really natural. Good for you. Like...
Right. None of your lab shit. Pure like nature. It's from Europe. Met a bloke at our gig last week who sorted us out. It's clean, you know? You don't wake up and everything hurts like the crap we normally get around here.
What about Cal, though? He hasn't come out of his pit all day.
Cars are lightweight. Let me sort you right out.
I don't know if you're really there. I'm starting to think this stuff isn't natural.
Good morning, James.
Moneypenny. That's very daintily secretarial of you.
I remember when you were charming. How was Helsinki?
Cold, wet, and full of fins. Should you be doing that on your desk?
What would you rather I be doing on my desk?
I remember when you were charming.
Em's expecting you, James. Go right in.
Good morning, sir.
Sit down, 007. Isn't it strange that the service struggles to obtain an efficient performance from you on any number of engagements, but that a straightforward revenge mission sees you in and out in 19 hours?
It was a simple operation, sir.
Killing a man is simple?
Simple as in a lack of complexity. No tradecraft required. All I had to do was locate the actor in question and eliminate him.
Yes, well, it's not gone unnoticed. People in high places are suggesting I retire the 00 section entirely.
And?
And the conducting of foreign policy still requires access to a small box of blunt instruments. You don't get to retire to the casino quite yet, Bond.
Sir?
Bill Tanner will be commencing a search for a new 008 later today. In the meantime, you'll be taking over 008's caseload.
But?
Your own caseload is hardly crippling 007, and the most urgent case on 008's is another simple job. We have a small, quiet, and peculiar drugs importer whom we would like to dissuade from doing business in the United Kingdom before they become a major problem.
Peculiar in what way, sir?
The lab hasn't quite isolated it, but something in the composition of the product is off. We are presuming it's a side effect of producing a synthetic in a small, perhaps mobile lab on the continent. The chemical signature does, however, make the product very easy to identify. We've already spoken to the cousins, and your friend Leiter has an informant in his stable who has offered his leads and aid through the CIA. You're off to Berlin to see him. Tanner will brief you. But before you two go to some appalling bar to pretend to work, you're to see the quartermaster. That's all. Off you go, 007.
Sir?
And leave Moneypenny alone. I consider her job to be much more important than yours.
Your Walther P99, please, 007. Horrible gun. This is a gun for ladies, 007, and not very nice ladies at that. Take it away.
Wait. I don't care if you like it or not, it's mine.
This morning, 007, MI6 was served with papers announcing an extension of the hard rule.
The hard rule says MI6 officers can't carry arms inside the United Kingdom, but you and I both know the 00 section is exempt.
Until this morning. Some absurd political mess. It'll blow over. But until then, your weapon and ammunition will be sent on via diplomatic pouch, and you'll draw arms on station. I couldn't interest you in a proper gun instead of that prostitute shooting instrument.
You could interest me in sending me on a mission with a bloody firearm.
Now, 007. New ammunition, a variant of the G2R radically invasive projectile. The rounds are segmented and break up after piercing the skin. One entry wound, 88 exit wounds, extremely precise in the air. Not enough energy to punch through armor, but even an off-target hit on flesh will render the enemy unable to respond.
Lovely. If only I had a gun to put them in.
And get a proper holster, 007. That floppy chamois leather thing will kill you one day.
A hard holster would spoil the line of my suit. And Moneypenny is sitting there cleaning her gun.
She's M's last line of defense in the event of a breach. Home security, not special operations. She's allowed.
Insane. Sending a 00 officer of all people outside the country without a gun. And it doesn't even make sense. I'll be outside the country.
Yes, James. But you have to travel through the country to get outside it.
Oh, God, they're going to make me go through airport security like a...
peasant? Pleb?
I was going to say civilian.
You'll be met at the airport by officers from Berlin Station who'll take you straight to your beloved gun. It'll be fine.
Bill Tanner, you sound like an exasperated nun at a convent school.
Perfect bloody description of being chief of staff these days. Political strangers peeping over the walls to see if they can catch us getting dressed. Which is why...
Yes, yes, I'll obey the hard rule extension. With a smile. What do we know about Felix's informant?
This might actually be fun for you. It's Slaven Kurjak. The inventor, the bionic stuff, the prosthetic hands and legs and so forth.
Oh yes, Serbian. Richer than God.
And that amazing genetic stuff too. All the machinery was his.
I wonder if he employs nurses.
Oh, good God.
Done. Mr. Masters continues to exhibit chronic chemical anhedonia. He cannot experience or process pleasure in any way. We have been discussing further therapies. Perhaps combining oxytocin with a gene-edited serotonin transporter. We should also consider direct neurological intervention.
Not just yet. Soon, I promise. But we have a little local trouble to take care of first. We may be able to deal with it immediately. But if not... You will have to kill this man tomorrow, Mr. Masters.
Can I make it hurt? Please?